Hi, Tom Lydon here in Chicago at the Morningstar ETF Conference. I'm here with Sal Bruno, Chief Investment Officer of IndexIQ. Great to see you, Sal.
Good to see you as well, Tom.
One of the big topics at this conference is tackling fixed income. You know, traditionally, a lot of advisors benchmark to the Barclays Agg, but there are more intelligent ways to do it these days.
Absolutely. And if you look at how the Agg has evolved over time, it is much different today than it was. Look at the debt issuance by the U.S. government has increased the weight of treasuries in the Agg, which a lot of people may not be aware of. So we think it's important to think about what's actually in your fixed income and realize that not one size fits all. So not maybe every investor needs to have just core Agg exposure. Maybe some want to get a little bit more return, maybe some want to get a little bit lower risk or higher yield. So we think there are ways to create solutions within fixed income using smart beta technology to try to custom tailor some of these better solutions.
So you've developed three tools that kind of touch on that atmosphere a little bit. Walk through that and how might that help a fixed income allocation?
What we've relied upon is looking at factors that have worked in the equity world and trying to port them over into the fixed income world. So momentum is a strategy that has worked well historically, not only in equities, but also in commodities and currencies and other asset classes. So we're really just taking that body of research that already existed on equities and trying to apply to different sectors of, say, the Agg. So we have two different products that rotate across different sectors of the fixed income of the Agg universe. One includes high yield, the other does not. And they both are doing that rotation to try and get better returns coming out of the Agg portion of the portfolio.
Okay, so talk specifically about what those sectors and how do they overweight and underweight?
So the sectors are basically five sectors for AGGE, which is one of our ETFs. It's investment-grade corporate, mortgage backs, short, intermediate, and long-term treasuries. They use both 45-day and 90-day moving average windows to try to overweight and underweight different sectors. So you want to overweight the sectors that have better momentum and underweight the sectors that have worse momentum.
Interesting. And then finally, high yield?
So in high yield, we think there is a place for investors who are looking for income. A lot of people are looking for income, but they're also worried, given where corporate credit spreads are over treasuries now, is at the low end of the historical average. It's only about 350 basis points. That's really close to where we've seen it at the low end historically. If that starts to rise, investors could actually get hurt as those rates are going up, even as they're trying to get income. So what we've done is we've come up with a way to sort the high yield universe into the highest volatility and the lowest volatility, using market implied information, so credit spreads and spread duration. And we only own the 50% lowest volatility bonds, trying to give you as much of the income as we can, but really trying to protect on the downside should spreads start to widen out again.
Gotcha. So again, this rolls off your tongue easily, but for the average advisor out there, they got to do their due diligence. So number one, they can go to your website at IndexIQ, correct?
IQETFs.com.
IQETFs.com. And then the other thing, if they want to talk to you and their team, are you guys accessible?
Absolutely. If you call our number, if you go to IQETFs.com, we can get you in touch and we'd be happy to have a conversation.
So it's about, you know, how does it use in the portfolio, what you might sell in order to buy it, what they might expect by this new portfolio construction, and then most importantly, you got a cap markets team that's there to be able to help with any trading needs, right?
Absolutely. So for us, the most important thing is education, knowing what you're buying, know why you're buying it, knowing what environments it should work well, what environments that might not work as well, and of course, implementation. Our capital markets team is second to none and happy to help facilitate any trades.
Excellent. Sal, as always, great seeing you.
Same here. Thanks, Tom.
Thank you.